When we teach circus, the goal is not to make students into professional circus performers. Our goal is really to help broaden their physical capacity and their mental capacity, and to help them realize more about what they actually can accomplish when they set their minds to something.
There we go. Now go to the sides, people who bring on hoops.
When we talk about learning circus, or even putting on a circus, as we do with the 7th and the 8th grades at High Mowing, we think a lot about what my mentor calls the invisible circus. You see a show, or you see the students practicing, and you see lots of things flying around, and it looks kind of crazy. But what's really going on is that they're actively developing their capacities, and not just physical capacities like strength and flexibility, although those are a very important thing that you get from circus, but also really mental capacities, the capacity to focus, the capacity to work with others, the capacity to restrain yourself and control yourself. All of those come from circus as well. One of the most rewarding things in my job is seeing a child go from thinking that they're absolutely unable to do something to suddenly realizing that they can do it, and just the excitement that that creates. And that's realization and a life skill that's applicable to so many other things than circus. So if you can really help them reflect on that process of, wow, you told me about 500 times, student, that you couldn't learn how to juggle, and now look, you're doing it. I wonder if that could apply to math, or to English, or to getting a job, or any other thing in your life, that if you really structure your practice and you work hard at something, you get there.
Can we run it again?
Yeah.
Great, let's run it again.
So one thing that I try and keep in my students' awareness is that circus, like almost everything, has very little to do with any sort of natural talent, and a lot to do with how much time you spend doing it. Certainly in my case, I was not a very coordinated young person when I started out, and it's really through, I think it's through persistence that I gained all of the circus skills that I currently have, and really I see that again and again with students. Maybe some are more coordinated and some are less coordinated, but the important thing is regular, steady practice to get to your next level. And that's really an important thing that it teaches, an important thing to keep in mind.
And now spotlight all of those boxes of juggling equipment.
My goal when directing the Hilltop Circus is to give the students as much voice as possible. It really should be a student-created production. So the students select which acts they want to be in, whether they're going to be in a unicycle act or a juggling act, or whether they're going to be a clown and kind of carry the story element throughout the show. Each act has an act captain and an act scribe who records their ideas, and a props captain and a costume captain. So it's really structured so that they take on responsibility for their creation, and that it come as much as possible from them. And then my job as director is to listen to all of their ideas and all of their input and weave it together into a coherent show. Circus at our high school is much more of a choice-based activity. On our Pine Hill campus, students in grades 4 through 8 have circus as a required part of their physical education. In high school, it's much more of an option. So just like you could take a pottery elective class or a culinary arts elective, students are welcome to enroll in a circus elective, and or a circus projects block even, where they spend 2 weeks intensely focused on one activity. Every student does get a little bit of circus as part of their morning movement, where they come in the morning and take an activity to get their blood flowing before they really sit down and start studying. So we do a little bit of juggling with each class there throughout the year, and some other circus as well. One thing that I love for students to take with them out of the program when they graduate is the confidence that they can learn almost anything, because when they came to the school, they probably weren't imagining that they would ever learn to juggle or ride a unicycle or hang from a trapeze, and being able to do that, I think, is a huge, huge confidence builder. I also love it for students to have a secret skill that no one else really knows about, and because Circus Arts as a leisure activity are certainly growing, but still not as ubiquitous as gymnastics or dance or soccer. It often gives our students something cool that they can bring to a new social situation, to be able to juggle or hold a handstand or do a backflip or anything else. Kind of makes them feel special and unique when they go out into the world, into new circumstances. And my biggest hope is that they also gain a love for teaching and that they're able to pass on these skills that they've learned in a safe manner to other people.